Hello everyone, welcome to Educate 24/7. This is the lecture 15th of SEBI Grade A 2020 special series. In our 15th lecture, we are discussing MCQs based on job costing, and this topic is very important for your upcoming examination. Educare 24/7 has launched crash course for SEBI Grade A 2020 examination. In this crash course, we are covering whole syllabus of paper 2 and GS of paper 1. We will be providing notes, topic wise MCQs and videos. Our content are very crisp and concise and very much relevant to your examination. Currently, we are also running discount of rupees 1000 on this course. That is a golden opportunity for you guys. You can use code SEBI to get that discount. So visit our website educate247.com and subscribe to the course. So let's start with the MCQs. Question number 1 says, which of the following is not a source document used in job order costing system? Options are cost of production report, employee timesheet, job cost sheet and material requisition form. So among these options, the correct one answer is cost of production report. So basically, we need to understand in this question what exactly about job order costing system. Basically, job order costing or job costing, both are same. So don't get confused. This is one of the method of costing, which is very important method, which used to calculate the cost of an individual unit of output in the company. So this is a method which assures the all the responsible cost incurred in the production of an individual unit of output, so that the company would be able to calculate the profit respect to the individual unit of output. Since there is a significant variation in the items manufactured, the job order costing system that is also for that requires a separate job cost, so that the record can be maintained by the company for each item in the company. This job cost will report each item's direct materials and direct labor that were actually used and assigned amount of manufacturing overhead. Here this word has used overhead. Overhead means all the indirect cost which are responsible for the production of a unit of output. Next we have question, select the response that represents the correct flow of cost in a job order costing system. So options are, option A says raw materials, work in process, cost of goods sold and finished goods. Option B says raw materials, work in process, finished goods, cost of goods sold. Option C says raw materials, overhead, work and work in process. Option D says direct material, finished goods and work in process. So the correct one is raw material, work in process, finished goods and last cost of goods sold. So this is the correct flow of cost which are calculating in the job order costing system. First, in the the basic flow of cost in a job order system begins by recording all the cost of raw material, then labor cost will be included, and last manufacturing overhead. Overhead means indirect cost which are responsible for the goods sold in the market. Let's suppose the example for, we can say, the salary of salesman whose main responsibility to sell the product in the market. So here a few things are very important to know. Direct material, direct labor cost are debited to the work in process account. Work in process means everything, all the manufacturing process are under the final procedure. So all the raw materials will come, all the unfinished goods will come. So these all the cost will considered as expenses. Hence, it is considered as debited in the account of company. Any indirect material or indirect labor cost are debited to the manufacturing overhead, because indirect costs are known as overhead. Hence, it is debited or maintained under the overhead control account. Along with any other actual manufacturing overhead cost incurred during this period, the cost of finished goods is credited to the work in process and debited to the finished goods inventory account. Inventory means all the stock, whether it is finished goods or unfinished goods. So basically, this inventory is a broader term. When units are sold, their costs are credited to the finished goods and debited to the cost of goods sold. Next question says, for a manufacturing company, indirect manufacturing cost may be included in option A, direct materials inventory only, option B, merchandise inventory only, option C, both work in process inventory and finished goods inventory, option D, direct materials inventory, work in process inventory and finished goods inventory accounts. So the correct answer is both work in process inventory and finished goods inventory. So here we need to calculate all the indirect manufacturing costs which are incurred under the work in process and also under the finished goods inventory. Here I have mentioned indirect manufacturing costs are manufacturer's production cost other than direct materials and direct labor. Indirect manufacturing costs are also referred to as manufacturing overhead, factory burden or internal burden. Next question we have, direct materials inventory would normally include option A, direct materials in stock and awaiting use in the manufacturing process, option B, goods partially worked on but not yet fully completed, option C, goods fully completed but not yet sold, option D, products in the original form intended to be sold without changing their basic form. The correct answer is direct materials in stock and awaiting use in the manufacturing process. So here the option A will be correct. Basically this question's demand is all the direct material inventory like raw material, the finished goods and also the under finished goods. So basically this inventory is all physical component that a company owns that will go into making a product. So still production, the making procedure is going on, it is yet to be completed. So here exclude those all the finished goods which are responsible for process inventory. In other words, we can say it is the amount of direct material that company has on hand. So we need to, whenever we solve the question, we need to focus on the question demand, what exactly it talks about. Next question we have, work in process inventory would normally include option A, direct materials in stock and awaiting use in the manufacturing process, option B, goods partially worked on but not yet fully completed, option C, goods fully completed but not yet sold, option D, products in their original form intended to be sold without changing their basic form. So among these options, the correct one is goods partially worked on but not yet fully completed. So in this term, the correct option will be B. So as I told you, work in process inventory means the stocks will be there, but it is under process. So yet the final goods will come out. There is a time to come out as a final product. Here clearly I have mentioned work in process, work in progress, both are same. Goods in progress, in the process inventory are a company's partially finished goods waiting for completion and eventual sale or the value of these items. So these items are either just being fabricated or waiting for further processing in a queue or a buffer storage. So this is all about the MCQs on job costing. Thank you and keep learning.